Hey YouTube, iPadX142 here, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how you can jailbreak iOS 11.0 to 11.4.1 using any iOS 11 compatible device with the brand new version of the Electra jailbreak. So this is a new jailbreak that's been released as an update to a previous version which was only compatible up to iOS 11.3.1. A new exploit was released a few days ago called Voucher Swap, which is now much more reliable than the previous exploit that was used and is also compatible with all versions of iOS 11 up to 11.3.1. So this is excellent news if anyone's still running iOS 11 and waiting for a jailbreak. You'll now be able to jailbreak rather than having to wait to update to iOS 12. So if you're happy to stay on iOS 11, use a jailbreak, and you don't want to wait for the iOS 12 jailbreak, then that's fine. You can go ahead and use this jailbreak. So it's very, very simple. This method is going to be showing you how to do it with a computer, whether it be a PC or a Mac or a Linux computer. But I'm also going to have another video showing you how to do this just on your device if you don't have a computer or if you just prefer to do it that way. So yeah, this is going to be showing you that method, but if you want to see the other one, it'll be linked in the video description below, so you can check that out if you're interested. But what you're going to want to do is have your PC ready, and on your computer you're going to want to have my website loaded up here. Go to the link in the video description where it says download links and written guide, and it'll bring you to my site here where you can find a full written guide on how to do this, lots of information about it, and all the download links you're going to need for this. So you're going to need to download two things. The first thing you're going to want to download is the Electra IPA file that you're going to be installing on your iOS 11 device, which is actually going to be able to actually function as the jailbreak and complete the jailbreak on the device. So you can go over to CoolStar's website here, which is linked there, and you can just see this download button here, which will download the latest version that's available, which at the time of making this video is 11 or 1.2.1. Yeah, that's the version that is compatible with iOS 11.4.1. So once you've got that, you're also going to need the latest version of Cydia Impactor. Now, if you already have this, just make sure you have the latest version, really, otherwise you may run into issues. So these download links here will download the latest version of each of them. So just go ahead and download the latest one. I've already got Cydia Impactor installed on my computer, saved somewhere. So if you've already got it, then that's great. But otherwise, just download it here. Windows, you'll get a zip file to just extract with an exe, and on Mac, you'll get an actual application file. And I think that's the same on Linux as well. But you can follow the written guide here if you prefer. But for this, we're going to be showing you how to do this manually. So, as you can see, I've got an iOS 11 device here. It's not currently jailbroken. This one's currently running iOS 11.1.1, but like I said, it will work up to 11.4.1. So once you've got both of those things, you basically want to make sure it's plugged into your computer, trusted and everything, so that iTunes can see it. And then basically you're just going to want to open up Cydia Impactor like so. I've got the shortcut here. And then once you open it up, you'll get something that looks similar to this. If you have multiple devices plugged into your computer at once, just make sure you select the correct one in the drop-down menu. So in my case, it's going to be this second one here. That's just don't get caught out by that, or you may end up installing it on the wrong device. But once you're on that menu here, you're going to want to go to the folder where your IPA file that you downloaded is, which is right here. And you're going to want to simply drag this on top of the Cydia Impactor window. At this point, it's going to ask you to log in with an Apple iTunes ID. So you can use your own one for this, or you can create a burner one that you can just use purely for this if you don't trust this. But this is only going through Apple servers. All it is doing is using this as a certificate to authenticate the application install. So there's nothing to worry about. But if you do have any concerns, you can always just create a second account and use that instead. So I'm just going to go ahead and enter my email address and password here, and then we will show you what happens afterwards. And once you press OK, it'll go ahead and start installing the application. If you do get an error here saying that you have something to do with certificates and anything like that, it even means that you entered your password wrong, which usually will specify that you entered your password wrong. But you can also have it so that if you've installed applications using this method before, you basically just need to revoke those certificates. So to do that, just go to the Xcode tab here, click on revoke certificates, enter your Apple ID, and it'll go ahead and revoke them. And hopefully after that, you shouldn't have any issues installing the application. But as you can see, that was very, very simple, and that is literally all we need the computer for now. So now we can do everything else on our device. As you can see, we've got the Electra application here on our home screen. If we try and open it up for now though, it's gonna give us an untrusted developer warning. So you just need to go over to the settings application, go to general, scroll down to profiles or profiles and device management, whatever one it says, and then you should see the Apple ID you used in here. So just tap on that, tap on trust again, and then you should be able to go out and open up the Electra application. Now, it is recommended that you run this application directly very shortly after rebooting your device. So sometimes it will actually warn you to do that here. We're not going to bother right now because I did reboot the device right before I started recording this video. But basically, if you do get that message, it's just recommended to do that. And this, because this doesn't always work the first time either. So you may get this where it'll run and then it won't actually work. It'll just crash and reboot and you'll have to run it again until it just starts to work. But this is much more reliable than previous versions of iOS or Electra, so you shouldn't have to try it as many times. So once you're in here, just tap on the jailbreak application and you should see it going through and jailbreaking the device. So we've got please wait here, it'll go through the steps, then it will install Cydia, and then it will respring the device, and then you'll be fully jailbroken just like that. Now it is worth mentioning as well that this is a semi-tethered jailbreak, so as in this case we can see it didn't work, so we're going to have to just reboot our device and try that again, so I'm just going to do that quickly. But while I'm doing that, basically I'll explain that the semi-tethered jailbreak part of this means that whenever you reboot your device after you've jailbroken, and once you bring it back up to the home screen, you will notice that none of your tweaks or themes or anything will be functioning, and that just means you need to rerun the jailbreak application. To do that, you basically just open it up and do the exact same thing we're about to do, except it'll do all the same process, except it won't install Cydia since it's already there. And then that's pretty much all you need to do. It'll just start working again. And then the other thing to bear in mind with this as well, the way that we are installing the application through Cydia Impactor is going to mean that unless you have a paid Apple developer account that you're using for this, you're going to have to reinstall the application every 7 days for it to continue to work. Otherwise, it will just stop working and you won't be able to actually re-jailbreak your device when it's, reboots for some reason. So that's something to bear in mind as well. There are ways around that where you can have it automatically re-signed, but that's not something we're going to cover in this video. If you want to have it to extend it for longer using the non-computer method, then you can do it that way as well. But as you can see, now that we've rebooted, we're just going to open up the application. Generally, it's best to leave it for a few seconds before you actually press the jailbreak button. It just seems to increase the chances of success. So once we've done that, just tap on jailbreak and we'll go through and do the same thing. Hopefully it'll work this time, but like I said, this isn't 100% guaranteed to work every single time, so you may find yourself needing to just try it a few times, maybe even 4 or 5 or more before it actually works. So that's just something you need to bear in mind. Unfortunately, it is a little bit annoying, but that's just something we have to bear in mind. So we're just going to keep trying this until it goes through. Like I said, this has just been released as well, so there may be some issues with older iOS versions and things like that. I've actually had this work fine on an iPhone SE in another video that I just did. It's exactly the same application, so there may be issues with that. But basically what it'll do is it'll go through and install Cydia. So we're just going to try this one more time, and hopefully it'll work this time. Okay, so for some reason I wasn't able to get it to work on that iPhone 6s running 11.1.1, but I have had it work on this iPhone SE running 11.3.1, so there may just be some issues with older versions that they need to sort out, which will hopefully be fixed in later versions. So if you do have any similar issues, then maybe you need to contact Coolstar and report those issues to him. I probably will after this. But if I should show you here on this device what the process basically looks like when you do jailbreak. So you have the application just like this, as we showed before. Tap on jailbreak, it'll go through and actually jailbreak the device. This one already has Cydia on it, but I've rebooted it, so it's not currently in jailbreak mode. It's not going to show installing Cydia like it would if you were doing this for the first time, but it should show the steps of the rest of it. So as you can see, it goes to 2 out of 3 and then 3 out of 3, and then it should respring your device and you should come back up and have Cydia fully functioning on your home screen. That's basically the process in a nutshell. There's not much more to it than that. Like I said, if you do have any issues like that, they're probably worth reporting to the developers, either on Twitter or wherever they prefer to have it. So there will probably be links on their site that you can report things like that. Unfortunately, if you do have any issues similar to what I just showed, then I probably won't be able to help you, just because it'll be an issue with the software and not with anything you're doing wrong, unfortunately. But as you can see, once that's happened, you'll be able to come back onto your home screen, have Cydia fully functioning, and that'll be that pretty much. This device isn't connected to the network at the moment, but it would normally show the normal screen there, and that'd be pretty much it. Like I said, you will have to rerun the application just like that we just showed there every time you reboot your device to enable your tweaks and Cydia and everything again. So that's something to bear in mind. But other than that, that is pretty much it. It's very simple to do. Like I said, the full written guide for this and download links will be linked in the video description, as well as the non-computer method if you prefer to do it that way. It's possible that this could have been, something to do with how I install the application. So maybe try the non-computer method if this one doesn't work for you, and that'll be linked in the video description below. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Like the video if you liked it. Leave a comment if you have any questions. And as always, don't forget to subscribe.